Right, I turn into my narcissist complex. No, really. But what I have today in the show of life is, I guess I put that one little image out, and it's going to be an image of my garden. It's starting, yeah, I have some beautiful chard. The potatoes are full and lush, and turnips are growing. And the radishes are already done. They grew really fast. Really fast. Okay, so certain things here are just like, yeah, out. Snap peas are working. They're like little sugar snaps. And the squash is starting. And it's becoming, you know, full as it goes. And that is exciting. And then next, well, I'm like working on the front garden. I put the rosemary bushes in today, and I'm relieved. They're in, I don't know. I made them opposite each other. I'm flanking the driveway, like a what do we call it? An army, my army of plants. I don't have people, so it'll be an army of plants, and so that's kind of fun. And then an orange tree. Now, I'm gonna put an orange tree out in the front garden. I know it says it goes to 30 degrees here, and the orange tree is not necessarily hardy any longer, and it's on the iffy side, but I'd rather put it out there, put a fruit tree out there, just because I don't see fruit trees in people's gardens in the front of their garden. And I think that helps, like on the paranoia wheel of crime and criminal. You know, if everybody has, you know, a fruit tree in the front garden, you know, what's the big deal? There's food. You know, we're not gonna die. You know, there's food. You know, so people can relax, live a more relaxed life. So if you have, you know, have that energy, put a fruit tree out there. And who cares if somebody comes and takes some of your oranges or your apples? Who cares? At least make that effort. And then the next people will, And then eventually, those people who run and grab your fruit and apples will go away. They'll be like, it's everywhere. You know, it's just everywhere. It doesn't matter. Yeah, so it's kind of a weird environment here in the Midwest, Southwest, because you can grow apples and you can grow oranges and you can grow avocados, apparently avocados at the minimum. It's everything's going to be like, and then watching this next winter will be like the worst winter ever. It'll be the 100-year winter where it all freezes. But it doesn't matter. You have to take the chance as, and even then the plant doesn't necessarily die. It just maybe some branches, and so, yeah. Ay, ay, ay. They sold me a bare root, a pear tree, and it hasn't even made a leaf on it yet, and I don't want to dig it up because I'm just too tired. So I have a bare root with no leaves, and I'm like, I'm sure it's dead, but it's still going to have to stay there. I don't know. I'll keep it there. grow something around it at the moment, but... yeah, so in the life of, I got some non-GMO seeds for the chard, and it was very nice to find non-GMO seeds, but I had to order them from a special company. You don't always get the non-GMO style, so you have to be, you know, really pushy with looking. If you shop at organic food stores, though, it's easy, you know, for potatoes, to grow potatoes, because you just take the potatoes that are organic and you use those as your seed potato, and it works fine. Just take some of those little ones, even cut them in half or quarters. They're easy. And sweet potatoes are working here also. I already have a big bushy sweet potato bush out of one mama potato. And the way those grow is just the whole potato, and you put it in water for about 4 to 8 weeks even. And then as soon as it starts to make leaves, if you put it out into the soil, and it starts to make lots of little babies. And so maybe 10 to 30 even are from one potato. So they're kind of neat. The sad thing is you're using that whole beautiful sweet potato or yam, and you're putting that in the ground, and you're like, ah, because it was a beautiful organic potato, you know. It's just an expensive seed. It's an expensive seed, but in the end, it pays itself off. So what else? What else did I have on my list of? Oh, I'm so excited with the genealogy lately. Aside from the fact that I am not the Mormon with the number, if I'm a Mormon and I have a Mormon number to assign to a ward, that means that I can take the GEDCOM file. See, silly me. I went to their site and I started entering everything and linking everything from my spreadsheet. And then I even took from the ancestor site. Went there and I linked things through, and then I saved the GEDCOM, and then I went to Family Search, and then I uploaded all these GEDCOMs, and so it's all there, and I'm like, yay, it's all there and together. And so now I was like, well, I wanted to put it right back on ancestor.com, and then I'm like, no, they don't let me take the GEDCOM. Even though I uploaded a GEDCOM and manipulated it and fixed it and pieced it together just till I'm out to, I don't know when, 700. But I've done all of these things, and now they won't let me take it, even to move it to Ancestor.com, which is their own money-making business. Now, their money-making Ancestor.com will allow for 4 generations only, and so that's like, well, that's no good, because that goes to the CVs, okay? And, well, that's nice, because, yes, they had more children than any other family on the face of the earth. I believe they were the largest family in all history, and that's who I stem from, is Mr. CV himself, George Washington CV. He had 3 wives, I believe, and then each one of those had 20 children. So it was a big family. And yeah, I think they own Utah, but it doesn't help me. It doesn't help me now, because I can't really get past those 4 generations without having to type everything I have in my little spreadsheet in. And that makes for fault. And also it hurts my eyes, it hurts my back. It's kind of abusive. Database abuse when the database is already there at the Family Search. So I'm like, well, I have to get at it. All right. I have to get at it somehow to put it back on the Ancestor.com, because there's no like linking to or talking to people or sharing. I can't have the database shared with any family members unless it's on the Ancestor.com. So I'm like, well, that's really great. So I match through. I've got all these kingdoms here and kingdoms there, and yet I can't even share from the Family Search site. So I'm like, well, this sucks. The whole thing is just kind of, what? If I'm a Mormon, though, I can take the entire GEDCOM. If I'm a Mormon and I have the number. And then I'm like, well, I understand that premise. If I'm a Mormon, I have the number. That's maybe interesting. However, I do not want to give 10% in tithings. Do you understand? So if I don't want to give 10% in tithings, I cannot claim myself as a Mormon, so therefore I cannot get the GEDCOM download. So I don't know. When I went through and I uploaded all these things, they should have said, oh, by the way, you know, you're just giving to us data. You're making connections for us, by the way. You're helping genealogists across the world, and you can't have it back. You know, they should have said, oh, by the way, You cannot have that file. Once you've pieced it, linked it all together. Unless you give us 10% in tithings. Yee! So no, I'm not gonna join the Mormon Church. I can't. I'm gonna be what do you call it? On the side. You know, I'm just gonna be one of those on the side. I like a lot of the firm, but then there's a lot of the firm I don't like. So I'll just be on the side of the Mormon Church, and I'm sorry, I cannot join. It would be nice for genealogy, though. It would be nice. I understand where they're at. It's their database. But however, those are my ancestors. Hello. They're my ancestors. And just because they're in the database, that database has been put together by people all across the world again and again and again. So in a way, how can one church just claim it just because they're running the servers, you know? They're running the computer machines, you know, that hoard all of this data. You know, how can they claim it as their technical, whatever, property? How can they claim it as theirs when it came from the backs and the labor and the work from people all over the place? I mean, my grandparents were genealogists their entire lives. And they're Mormons. They're, you know, they got the number, they paid their tithings. But it doesn't mean I get access to the GEDCOM. You understand? And it's kind of bogus, because if the people like three generations after weren't Mormon, why does the Mormon Church get that claim? You know what I mean? Why would you get that claim? They're not even Mormon. I know, it's about going and gathering the dead, they say, and then turning them into being Mormon, and I know that there was that thing going on. You get listed in the database, we'll turn you into Mormon anyway after you're dead. That's another strange thing the Mormons do, and I really don't care, actually, about that, because that's after you're dead. But unfortunately, yeah. So I am sad. They're only dishing out this little measly four generations. Anyway, so I'm working with Python now, and I don't know anything about Python, and it's a programmer script thing, and I have to debug a program, and so that's going to take me a while, but it's thrilling. Because maybe I can bypass the Mormon Church a little bit, and maybe I can get generations past the first generation me. Maybe that would, you know, be better. Because there's no way I cannot get, you know, my database rewritten into the ancestor.com. You know, I'm just gonna go blind, and I'm gonna make errors. And the whole point of everything is if it's already in the database, I just have to click yes. That's the one. Yes, 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 yes. That they don't even have that simplicity. It's very, very complicated and convoluted, and it's just like you can't just click yes, yes, yes. No, they didn't make a good output. So yeah, I'm not happy with how they programmed it, because it's too tight. Programmed it too tight for Mormons only, and I don't want to have to join the church and give 10% tithings to get the database of my kingdoms, my you know, whatever. So anyway, so back to, oh, fun news on my dad's side of the family. I found out there's another Kennedy, so now I've got Kennedys on both sides. My mom and dad, I have a Catherine Kennedy. I haven't researched on where she goes yet, but that's always fun. It's always fun to find a Kennedy. And Scottish kings. Yeah, my dad's side now has Scottish kings. They're much older Scottish kings, Malcolm, back then. But it's fun. It's fun to find that they go back to Scottish kings. That's the Sayers that go back through to the Fairfaxes, to the Leighlins, that group. There's a group that goes that way. And the Lyon is Lyon, which is the same spelling as in France, as the city, Lyon. I went there, and my car broke down, so I know Lyon, just outside of Lyon, 10 miles, 25 miles from the big city, and then yeah, so I know that place. But anyway, that's all I'm doing right now. That's all I'm doing, and like I said, it's kind of a relief. It took me 3 months of real dedicated gardening, and it's a relief now because the food is now being supplied out in the back garden there, and I don't have to go to the grocery store and buy, those simple things. I don't have to buy them now. I don't have to buy the chard. I don't have to buy the potatoes. I don't have to. It's just thrilling. It's like, if you have the time, if you have that energy, if you have that, make sure it's not chemical soil also, of course. Try to, bolster that soil up as best you can, so it's not chemical, or from the grasses, the grass that was grown before. And in a way, I guess certain areas will even tell you. If they're not blooming out really big and full, they'll tell you, well, maybe there was something ugly there. Already some sort of pestiside. Anyway, so that's where I'm at. And the what the heck? Flowers. Don't forget flowers. You have to have flowers. And the hummingbird needs flowers. All of these little bees need flowers. So it's they're hand in hand. Just, you're growing your vegetables, you also have to have your flowers, because then you have the bees, and the bees go into the fruits, and then the hummingbirds have the food, and everybody's excited, yeah. And that's it. And that's all I have right now. What was my big genealogy at the moment? I guess they're trying to get us really heavily into Pedro, the king of the area of Navarre, Spain. Heavily of an into Pedro, which was he's an interesting one, Pedro Aguirre, but and he's very recent, 1600 time. The only thing about Pedro, which is odd for me, is his father. They have his father now listed as being from Bolivia, and I'm like, whoa, now we've got us in Bolivia, so that's neat. And what I am finding out is a lot of that area of Spain did move to this southwest region, did take over as Spaniards. They were the Inquisition. They were that group that really was Catholicism or else. And they still are pretty heavy in it here. But the Dantriantria, those Indians that were here, some of those Indians married in. Some of those Indians had to convert or die. History was awful. They abused the Indians. They were mean to the Indians, like you can't believe. They treated them slaves, as slaves. And just terrible. So, yeah, so I'm looking at my Indian side being the Enriquez, and the reason I'm saying that great grandmother of mine is Indian is because, aside from her facial features and everything, I found a silversmith, a Navajo silversmith, and his name is Enriquez. He's a famous one, but I haven't been able to contact him at all. So the Navajo Indians did start to adopt that name of Enriquez. So that's interesting. And a lot of them, like that Melendres family, and that one. You know, all of those are probably some type of mix. A lot of mixes happened. Spanish and Native American Indians. Okay. All right. That's that. And I'm sorry, I don't have anything else to say. I'm just gabbing, and I'm going to go work on debugging a Python script. And hopefully I can gather a better database for the ancestor.com. And I don't know what to say, except it would be nice if the Mormon Church, you know, made that free for everybody, because why hide it? You know, what's the secret? There is no secret. They're just names in history. A lot of them were cousins. Gosh, I had a lot of cousin marriages in the, on the, over there in the French Spain. A lot of cousins. Yeah. Nothing we could do about it. It's just the way they were, I guess. All right, so I'm back to KW8C3K7.